Good evening, everyone. Happy Diwali. The morning news you must have seen. Karnataka government takes back land inside Lalbagh given to two societies, the Nurserymen Cooperative Society and Mysore Udyana Kala Sangha. These two societies own 1.65 acres of land and 70 cents of land respectively. However, the Karnataka government's horticulture department will take back these lands, and their bone of contention is that these societies make huge profits, paying only negligible amount as renewal fees. This is news, but something connected with horticulture and growing plants. Welcome on board Luke's ship of parables of Jesus Christ. Can you make a guess which parable we are going to meditate now? Yes, it's about plants, growing plants. Even nowadays we have great fancy for growing air purifying plants, indoor plants as well. I think it strikes your mind. It is the parable of the vineyard and the owner. This is the parable of the vineyard and the husbandman and the owner. Luke chapter 20, if you read verses 9 to 17 verses, let me read it for you. Luke 20, verses 9 onwards. Now Jesus turned to the people again and told them this story. A man planted a vineyard, leased it to tenant farmers, and moved to another country to live for several years. At the time of the grape harvest, he sent one of his servants to collect his share of the crop. But the farmers attacked the servant, beat him up, and sent him back empty-handed. So the owner sent another servant, but they also insulted him, beat him up, and sent him away empty-handed. A third man was sent, and they wounded him and chased him away. What will I do? The owner asked himself. I know. I'll send my cherished son. Surely they will respect him. But when the tenant farmers saw his son, they said to each other, here comes the heir to his estate. Let's kill him and get the estate for ourselves. To possess the property, to possess the estate for themselves, they even stooped down to take the lives of the heirs of the estate. To that extent of genocide, we can go ahead with. Here comes the heir to the estate. Let's kill him and get the estate for ourselves. So they dragged him out of the vineyard and murdered him. What do you suppose the owner of the vineyard will do to them? What's the result? What's the outcome? Jesus asked, I will tell you, he will come and kill those farmers and lease the vineyard to others. How terrible that such a thing should ever happen, his listeners protested. Jesus looked at them and said, then what does the scripture mean? He quoted the scripture. The stone that the builders rejected has now become the cornerstone. Everyone who stumbles over that stone will be broken to pieces, and it will crush everyone it falls on. The teachers of religious law and the leading priests wanted to arrest Jesus immediately because they realized he was telling the story against them. They were the wicked farmers, but they were afraid of the people's reaction. This looks to be a property dispute, a dispute of the estate, who it belongs to. So the tenant farmers killing the heir of the estate. They beat him, they beat the first servant and sent him away empty-handed. They beat the second servant and sent him empty-handed. This is the greed, obsession, possessiveness. Rather, it is the greed, I think. I believe it. And ultimately, when the cherished son, the only beloved son of the owner was sent, he was dragged out and he was killed, massacred. Who is here is like metaphorically described. The owner of the vineyard is God himself, and the cherished son, the only begotten son of our living Father God, is Jesus Christ. Let's analyze this parable. We see here God gives humans the free will to act. Free choice of action is bestowed upon us. We have the free will to choose. The fruit of the vineyard is the faithfulness that God's people owe to God. If we are God's people, we owe our faithfulness, we owe our loyalty towards God. And the servants who were sent to the vineyard are the prophets, who call people to obedience, the prophets who call people to repentance, the prophets who call people to turn to God. The word of God says, they did not listen to me. They did not incline their ear, and they turned stiff-necked in their attitude. So far is the story already happened. Then what is the story yet to come? God, our living Father, he will act, he will react. God will destroy these leaders, the word of God says. In the verse, I will tell you, when the owner comes, he will come and kill those farmers and leave the vineyard to others. This is like a time of judgment, a time of punishment, like condemnatory parable it sounds to be. It's like a condemnatory parable. It reveals persecutors and murderers as well. The wrongdoer shall not go unpunished. God shall condemn their acts. That's what the word of God says. The stone that the builders rejected has now become the cornerstone. The cornerstone, the foundation is Jesus Christ. And everyone who stumbles over the stone will be broken to pieces, and it will crush anyone it falls on. This is the punishment, this is the judgment the unbeliever shall face. This is the story yet to come. Here, Israel and the Jewish people are the chosen people, but he took away this privilege and gave this privilege to a special people, a peculiar generation, a peculiar people that follow Jesus Christ. The believers are peculiar people. That is the church worldwide. So the kingdom of God is given to the church worldwide, and they shall bear fruit. Let's pray. Heavenly loving Father, we come to thy feet this moment, all the viewers and myself in one heart, in unity we come to thy feet, O Lord. Bless us to be good husbandmen of God's vineyard as we follow the Lord and Savior. We shall be bear fruit, and our fruit is faithfulness that we owe unto our Lord. Bless us that we shall be faithful unto you. Bless us that we shall be loyal unto you. Bless us that we shall be obedient unto you, O Lord. Give us a soft heart that we shall follow thy word, and we shall adopt thy word in our lifestyle, and our Christian lifestyle stands a testimony of the Lord and Savior Jesus Christ among the people around us. Thank you, God. Listen to the prayer supplications of all the viewers of this presentation as they pray unto you with tears, as they kneel down at your feet and pray unto you and look unto you for your miracles to be performed in their lives, O God. Bless them abundantly. Bless this word of God, and bless this time of meditation upon thy word, and bless this presentation. Bless us all. In Jesus' precious name I ask, Amen. Amen. Thank you for being with me. See you next with the next parable of the Gospel of Luke. Bye-bye for now. Bye-bye.